talk to you about Guide Dogs for the Blind Association. The reason I've chosen this topic is simply because it's a sensational charity and deserves to be noticed. My heroes are the thousands of guide dogs and volunteers that work for Guide Dogs for the Blind Association. Guide dogs aren't just born with the talent of being able to guide someone across the road. Oh no, it takes many pairs of hands, or paws should I say, to achieve this. For example, there are 1,000 members of committed staff, 10,000 volunteers, and around 1,300 puppies that are trained by Guide Dogs for the Blind Association. Guide Dogs volunteers pitch in doing key jobs, such as puppy walking, breeding, driving, branch work, and fundraising. The Guide Dogs for the Blind Association officially was founded in 1934, although the journey began in 1931 with two courageous women called Muriel Crook and Rosamund Bond. These remarkable women set up the training of the first four British guide dogs in a garage in Merseyside, Wallasey. As you can imagine, the Guide Dogs for the Blind Association has come a long way since from where it began. Guide Dogs for the Blind Association is now the largest breeder and trainer of working dogs, and as a result of that, has helped 29,000 people regain life-changing independence. The Guide Dogs for the Blind Association has a fascinating history, but it is also working on ways to improve things. For example, in the last 4 years, it has set up the Buddy Scheme. The Buddy Scheme is a scheme to help younger people who are blind or partially sighted engage with their community. Furthermore, since 1990, Guide Dogs for the Blind Association has funded ophthalmic research to help investigate the ways to preserve sight and vision loss. Projects have focused on finding more efficient ways to diagnose and treat people who are blind and partially sighted. As part of this programme, the organisation has also funded projects such as Leber's Congenital Amaurosis that affects young children. Finally, the Guide Dogs for the Blind Association strongly campaigns for issues that affect blind or partially sighted people's daily lives. Such issues have focused on the inclusion of audiovisual equipment on buses, encouraging shops and public services to provide level access to buildings, and making local authorities aware of the problems caused for blind people obstacles on the street. Overall, the Guide Dogs for the Blind Association is an amazing charity that enhances people's lives. Let's hope it gains the funding it needs to carry on doing some valuable work for many more years to come. Thank you.